Hi YouTube, it's Feather Chick 1130, and what I'm talking about today is about taking care of your hair and like hair dyeing. It's a little strange too. I woke up like 10. So stop it, Kane. No. Sorry, my brother's being annoying like always. So yeah. I dyed my hair. If you can see it, I don't know if you can. I'm sorry. I got sunburned, so I'm like peeling. I dyed my bangs and I dyed pieces all over. It's kind of hard. There's not really great light in here. But, yeah. Sorry about the sound. So what I'm gonna start with, and hair clips, are we talking about? These.
What?
You can't buy this one anywhere because I made this one. Oh, my mom actually made it. And yeah, my mom made this. And so I'm going to show you how to make it. I'm not going to be making it right now, but I'm going to show you the instructions. So you just need to take a piece of felt, like close to the color of your hair, because my mom's hair is like really dark like this. Then you just need one of these. I call it a slip clip. One of these kind of clips that look like this. And then you hot glue them together, and then you just layer it with your feathers. You can get them at www.etsy.com, and you can get them on eBay. You can get them at Michael's, your local Michael's craft store, or anything like that. So you can see these, and you can see And my mom also hot glued these really pretty jewels. And so, yeah. I probably wear this out too much. And I'd wear it maybe in a bun. Or like that. No. So, you can wear this however you want. So I'm just going to show you. It's actually kind of pretty. You can see jewels and stuff. So yeah, I'm just gonna take this out. So you can comment below and tell me if you know how to make it and stuff. So I just dyed my hair. I use Frost and Glow on the front. It looks like kind of like furry a little bit. I don't have the box. I threw it out. Sorry. But yeah, I'm also going to talk to you about taking care of your hair. So if you have curly hair, I have curly hair. I usually straighten my hair or blow dry my hair because I don't really love my curls. I don't love my curls with dirty blonde hair and the highlights. So, but I came out of the pool yesterday. My hair's kind of wavy because I put something in. I straightened my hair on Friday or Thursday. So it kind of stayed. Now it's still wavy. But if you have curly hair, you're going to use sulfate-free stuff. I use a lot of stuff for my hair, the curly hair and hair and stuff. And for wavy hair and stuff, I don't really have wavy hair. I usually only have wavy hair when I straighten my hair, because it's only a little wavy. Because I can't make my hair be pin straight, really. I used to be able to, because I used to have pin straight hair. I have a gap in between my teeth. Oh my god, I just realized that. I look like I'm myself a Lady Gaga or something like that. Madonna. The gap in between my teeth. So, comment about the gap in between my teeth. Stuff like that. So, I use this volumizing stuff, and it strengthens your hair, and it volumizes your hair too. And you can't see them right now, but I have feathers in my hair. See right there? So sorry. Yeah. And I cut my bangs at all. When I'm doing my hair curly, I just straighten my bangs. So what I do is I take my bangs and I straighten, and then I start here. And then right when it's at your scalp, you turn. And then you go down and go in towards your face. So you get that nice little thing here. So, that's mostly it. Just, if you have curly hair, don't use sulfate-free stuff. Use volume wise and stuff if you want more volume. I'm going to make another video about the stuff I use. And then I'm also going to make another video of unboxing the Kintu. And unboxing my 11 shirts from Belio's. That's gonna be like Wednesday, Thursday. I'll take a video of that too. So I'll catch you in a few minutes so you can see what I use for my hair. Shampoo, conditioner, and shampoo and conditioner for my curly hair. Okay, bye.